Welcome to the first edition of Xtreme Buffalo Sabres. My name is Joey Schwanz, and joining me today is new Buffalo Sabres owner Jerry Pujulak.
Thanks for having me on here, you Schwanz. Now, before fans start clamoring for mass firings, I have to tell you that this whole ownership change thing is going to take time. However, for Darcy Regier, he will soon be going on the dole.
That's welcome news in these parts, considering how stale an operation this franchise has become. The fans certainly want changes, a number one center, and perhaps bring back the organ music.
I think we can accomplish a lot more than that. Tim Connolly is heading out the door for picks, and Craig Rieva is heading to the glue factory.
So I take it the days of small market banter, hope tanks, building from within, compete levels, needing focus, limitations, energy and other assorted buzzwords by this current milquetoast operation will cease to exist when you take over.
Eventually we will turn this thing around. For starters, I will recommend to Lindy to burn his Paul Bearer attire.
They need to spell Rob Niedermeyer's name correctly on his jersey. If he's wearing it by March 1st.
I before E. Except after C.
Being that you have roots with Penn State, will you be bringing in Joe Paterno as a consultant?
I believe we would avoid that. I have several hockey gurus lined up to lead this franchise to a championship.
Such as?
You'll have to ask Kevin Pordupont over at the Boston Globe.
Is Tyler Myers the greatest Sabres player ever? Expanding on that, is he possibly the greatest person in the history of people?
I don't believe I am qualified to answer those questions.
Is it possible that you will indeed hydrofrag the hell out of this franchise?
Let's be honest here, this franchise is definitely in need of an enema. A violent enema where all sorts of things come flying out. If you feel that equates to hydrofracking, then so be it.
Will you hire Craig Patrick to be the new general manager of the Buffalo Sabres?
He is a candidate for certain, but I can't divulge any information beyond that.
What about St. Patrick? Maybe he could drive the snakes out of the Sabres franchise and help make the ownership transition easier for you.
That's not really in the plans. There may be snakes in the Sabres franchise, and I am led to believe that there are, but they will meet their fate with a pink slip.
Is Scotty Bowman in the mix anywhere?
Judging by the reaction of your audience, I think you know where that stands.
I'm curious. And sometimes this kills the cat, but I have to ask you. Will there be a change in the concessionaires? A nice brew pub would go a long way to soothing the ills of watching this team. I realize this franchise isn't going to win in the very near future, so being nicely tanked would go a long way in keeping the fans interested, myself included.
That will be given consideration. Maybe we will bring in the hard liquor as well and make it like a game at Memorial Auditorium. The kind of games I remember from the 70s, when well soused lushies showed up and raised hell.
A good idea, although it will run counter to Bettman's sanitized league. Will you try and trade a player like Jason Pominville in order to keep the rest of the players on their toes? Like, say for instance, you decide for the hell of it to move a player of some significance off the roster to perhaps get the attention of the rest of the team.
I will say right now that no one's job is safe. That whole Drury and Brier fiasco still haunts this franchise. That nickel and dime crap comes to an end once I own the team.
Let's get down to the nuts and bolts. What date will you assume ownership of this franchise?
That will be the date when I have the money to give to Big Tommy G.
The date when you have the money, not the idea that you have to get the money and then set a date to purchase the team. Am I reading you right?
I will own the team when I have the money to own the team, and not one day sooner.
You already have the money, so why not set a date to purchase the team? No one is interested in another Mark Hamister situation.
Ah-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. I was just fucking with you. I have the money.
That's quite the relief for this poor Chester-like community. Well, good sir, I want to thank you for your time. I wish you good luck in your new endeavors.
You're more than welcome. Fans should sit back and watch the pink slips fly all around downtown Buffalo in the near future.
For Jerry Pagale, I'm Joseph Schwantz, bidding you a good night from our studios in Bowmansville.